नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छु। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
डियर चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल लर्न स्टैंडर्ड 9 सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 12। द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज इंडियन डेमोक्रेसी। नाउ डियर चिल्ड्रन, यू नो वेरी वेल दैट इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न अबाउट द मीडिया ऑफ द पब्लिक ओपिनियन इन डेमोक्रेसी। Two types of media are there. One is a print media and second one is a electronic media. The print media, dear children, we have to learn that in today's world, newspaper, periodical, journal that hold almost importance in facilitating the people to know about the indigenous events and the situation taking place nationally as well as the internationally. Also, we have learned that it is the essential that the opinion created are true, firm and unbiased. And because of that, we can say that here the media has given the freedom of press so that a false public opinion is not created by presenting only the achievement of government and thereby hiding the fault, failure and or shortcoming of the government. After we have learned about the electronic media. In the electronic media, dear children, we have to learn about audio visual media like radio, television, cinema, etc. are the important in cultivating the public opinion. Also, we have to learn that in today's world, we know very well that apart from television, the arrival and the spreading of the internet has helped the people to enjoy the news, serial, drama, movie, sitting completely in their homes. Now dear children, today we have to learn about the types of the democracy. The types of democracy means Lokshahina Prakara. Various countries in the world have the democracy. Dear children, you know very well that the various nations here in the world have a democracy. There still exists the diversity within the various democracies of the different country. Whatever can be children, we can say that there is still the existence in the diversity within the various democracy of the different country. Our country is a parliamentary democratic system underlining the children. Whatever that there, even that India has a parliamentary democratic system. In a country like USA, there is a presidential parliamentary system underlining the children. Both are the different one. India parliamentary democratic system, while in the USA there is a presidential parliamentary system. We shall see in the detail about these two types of democracy. One is known as a parliamentary democracy and the second one is a presidential democracy. First of all, dear children, we have to learn about the parliamentary democracy. It means Sansadiya Lok Shahi, that is known as a parliamentary democracy. Our country has accepted the parliamentary democracy. Dear children, you know very well that India has accepted the parliamentary democracy. Which one? Underlining our country, India has accepted the parliamentary democracy. In this, we can say that in parliamentary democracy, the president appoint, remember that dear children, the president appoint the leader of the party who get the majority number of the seats in the Lok Sabha as the prime minister. I am repeating what they are saying, that dear children, remember that in parliamentary democracy, the president appoint the leader of the party who get the majority number of the seats in the Lok Sabha as a prime minister. If you have to see about the Lok Sabha, then dear children, we have to learn in chapter number 10, the organs of the government, about the Lok Sabha. Just we have to revise it there. Lok Sabha is a lower house of the parliament. Dear children, you know very well that Lok Sabha is known as the lower house of the parliament. The member of the Lok Sabha are the representative of the people. Be careful and remember, in Lok Sabha, we can say that the member of the Lok Sabha are the representative of the people who are elected through the direct election. There are in all 545 members of the Lok Sabha. What they are saying there in the original? There are in all 545 members of the Lok Sabha. Out of this 545 member, two members are selected by the president from the Anglo-Indian community. In dear children, you know very well that president is a part of the parliament, Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. The president addressed the first meeting of the parliament and joining session of the parliament. Beside this, two occasions, the president never attend the parliament. So dear children, this all these things about we have to learn into the chapter number 10. After dear children, they have also given that the prime minister formed the government. What happened then, dear children? The prime minister formed the government. The parliamentary government is completely accounted to the Lok Sabha. Dear children, remember that word. We can say that the parliamentary government is completely accountable to the Lok Sabha. Government remain in the power as long as it enjoy the confidence of the majority of the member of the parliament. What they are given the dear children? They are saying that government remain in the power as long as it enjoy the confidence of the majority of the member of the parliament. And dear children, you know very well that in the parliament we have a Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha it is known as a lower house of the parliament. And the Rajya Sabha, already we have to learn into the chapter number 10 in the organ of the government. Just we have to revise. The Rajya Sabha is the upper house of the parliament. And it is the representative of the house of the all the state. Remember that dear children, what is the Rajya Sabha? Rajya Sabha means it is the representative house of the all the states and the union territories of the India. There are in all 250 members in the Rajya Sabha. In Rajya Sabha, 250 members are there. While in Lok Sabha, there are the 545 members are there. We remember, dear children, the members of the Rajya Sabha are indirectly elected. What? Lok Sabha's members are directly elected. Why? In Rajya Sabha, the members are indirectly elected by the member of legislative assemblies of the states in the union territories. Through this method, the equivalent representation, 238 members of the Rajya Sabha are elected, while the rest, 12 members, are nominated by the president of the India. So, this nominated member should have the special knowledge as well as the practical experience with the respect of literature, science, art, culture, sports, and the social services. So, dear children, what happened there? We have already learned in detail about Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha in the chapter number 10. Just you have to see this previous video also about the chapter number 10. So, here, dear children, we know very well that in the parliament democracy, we have very well that here in parliament democracy India is accepted. In India, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha is there. So here, the government remain in the power as long as it enjoy the confidence of the majority of the member into the parliament. After dear children, second one, they were given the information about the presidential democracy. Which one, dear children? Presidential democracy. Here, the presidential democracy is the second important types of the democracy. Which one? Dear children, presidential democracy is the second important types of the democracy. In a such type of democracy, the president is directly elected by the people. Dear children, underline. This is the most important thing. In presidential democracy, the president is directly elected by the people. It means presidential democracy means Pramukhiya Lok Sabha. While in the parliamentary it means Sansadiya Lok Sabha. Both are different. Remember, here we can directly elect the president in presidential democracy. Dear children, you know very well that presently the Donald Trump is the president of the America. But after the election, now new president of America, 46th, is the Joe Biden, is the new president of the America, who is presently elected as a president against the Donald Trump, who winning the presidential election. Now, who will be the new president of America, dear children? We remember Joe Biden will be the new president of United States of America and 46th president of the America. So here, dear children, they would given that here no public are directly elect their president. That's why they would given that in such a type of democracy, the president is directly elected by the people. The presidential remain in the power for specific period as mentioned as per their constitution. Presidential democracy is prevalent in many countries, including the USA. Not even China. Would they even that they would even that presidential democracy is prevalent in many countries, including the USA. And already you are watching the USA presidential election presently, and Joe Biden will be the 46th president of United States of America. Joe Biden winning against the Donald Trump, who is the presently the president of America. Thank you, dear children.
Thank you for joining us.